I'm glad you brought up the, well, first of all, where did you shoot?
In New Jersey for a lot of it, which is where the show takes place.
Yeah.
And around New York, and our stages were at Silver Cup in New York, in Queens.
I'm glad that you mentioned filming in cars. We don't talk that much about it on the show. And I think in a situation like this, where I'm hoping, it sounds like you did it pretty much practically. You didn't do car stuff in studios. Maybe I'm wrong. But talk to me about your approach to car shots.
Yeah, I mean, when I came on, I more or less assumed that we would have to do some things in studio with cars, because there's quite a few scenes over several pages of dialogue, some of them involving the two child actors at night, which is very limiting when you're shooting, because of the hours that you can work with them, and especially night hours that you can work with them. But they were pretty set on it, and for the most part, we shooting it on location, driving in a car, and for the most part, we did. There's the only time we actually took it into the studio was when we had to do a few pickup shots on those kids from when we had been down in Washington D.C. shooting a scene, driving at night, where we got most of the footage on the night, but then we still owed a few shots with the kids, and we shot that on stage with green screen outside the windows. But so our approach for shooting the moving car, for the most part, and these are also their cars from the 30s, you know, since the show takes place in 1940. They have a tendency to not always work as well as you hope. So our main way of shooting it would be that we would tow the car on a camera car that would have a techno crane on the back of it. That way we were able to move the camera around on the outside of the car, to quickly find different angles. So we wouldn't necessarily use the techno crane to make big sweeping shots. I mean, there's certainly your camera moves occasionally, but the main reason was to get all the different camera angles that we needed to get in a quick fashion, so that you could line up on a two shot through the back window, shoot it over and over until you have it, and then have the crane reset to a shot on the other side of the car without having to stop and make a new rig and that kind of thing. So it just was the most expedient way to do that. The daytime stuff, we just let the daylight light the interior of the car, I think with the sensitivity of the cameras these days is actually quite fine. It looks the best because it's just the most real. At nighttime, we installed LED strips into the ceiling of the car under the fabric. So we had them installed before they put the ceiling fabric inside the car, and they would be on eight different circuits, so that we could, as we were driving, if we were lining up on that side shot, we could make sure that we turned on the LED strips that were not visible on camera very quickly by a dimmer board operator that would sit on the camera car as well next to me, and he could dial those eight circuits individually in terms of like the brightness, if we wanted the one that's slightly from the back a little bit stronger than the one that's slightly right over the camera, for instance. But because they were recessed under the fabric, if they were off, they were not visible at all. They were on, they were lighting through the fabric, which was pretty heavy, but LED strips are very strong, especially for night work. So with some testing, we knew that we were going to have enough light out of them. And the ones that are in a position, like a lot of times you see some portion of the ceiling on camera, that portion of the ceiling, we would just then make sure that was turned off. So that worked pretty well. And on a few occasions, we even, when we did do a camera move, we would have the dimmer board operator ride the levels so that as the cameras transition from one side into the front, certain ones would fade out as we, and another one would fade on as we did that move.